What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and today Apple released iOS 15.3 just a few weeks after the release of iOS 15.2.1. And along with this iOS release, Apple also dropped iPadOS 15.3, WatchOS 8.4, tvOS 15.3, HomePodOS 15.3, and macOS Monterey 12.2. But in this video, we're going to be discussing what's new in iOS and iPadOS 15.3, including a major bug fix that you need to be aware of. And we're also going to talk about the performance, the battery life, and if you should update or not. Also, if I notified you of this update before your phone did, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. I post these videos every single time a new iOS update drops. All right, so before we get into what's new in this update, let's go ahead and briefly talk about the size and the build number. So you can see here, iOS 15.3 came in at just over 1 gigabyte for me, coming from iOS 15.2.1. That size will vary depending on your device and the version you're coming from, but it should be right around 1 gigabyte. And if we head into our settings, general about, you can see the new build number here for 15.3 is 19D50. And then if we scroll down to the modem firmware, you can see that has now been updated to 1.41.06. So if you're having any issues with connectivity, that could be resolved thanks to this modem firmware update. All right, so now what's new here in iOS 15.3? And this is mainly going to be a bug fix and stability update, since we did get quite a few new features in 15.1 and 15.2. Now, there are some notable changes with this update, but I'm just saying 15.4 and 15.5 are likely going to be more notable changes because we will be seeing those new wallpapers and emojis coming at some point in the future, but they are not in 15.3, unfortunately. But anyways, the first thing I want to talk about is a new private relay alert. So private relay, the iCloud Plus feature, will now show an alert if your carrier disables this feature, and it gives you more clarity as to why the feature is not working properly or just not working at all. And the main reason that Apple added this little alert right here is because T-Mobile actually came out and blamed Apple for a bug in iOS 15.2 that supposedly disabled the private relay feature. And they were telling their customers that it was an iOS bug, when in reality, it was actually a T-Mobile, you know, limitation of this feature, and it would disable it or just cause it not to work properly. So Apple had to come out and tell everybody with this new update that it's not an issue with iOS, it's actually your carrier turning this feature off if it does so automatically. So keep that in mind if you are a T-Mobile customer. We also have a minor change for the podcast application. So when you go to your library tab and then to your latest episodes and you're all caught up and you've listened to all of your podcasts in this section, we now have some new verbiage right here. So before in iOS 15.2 over here on the left, it said no latest episodes, but now in 15.3 here on the right, you can see it now says all caught up. We also have some minor verbiage changes when we go into our legacy contact section. So if you go to our settings here and go to our iCloud section and then password and security and then down to legacy contact, you can see the verbiage changes from iOS 15.2 on the left to 15.3 on the right. It's shorter and more to the point. Also, it now says your legacy contact up top. Before it was plural, it said your legacy contacts with an S. So just some minor verbiage changes here inside the legacy contact section. We also have some minor improvements to the shortcuts application, mainly when editing shortcuts and adding shortcut actions. So there's a lot less lag than there was previously. And then also the edit reminders action now works as intended. There were some issues with that on 15.2.1. Now, as far as bug fixes go, this is going to be the most important part of iOS 15.3. This is going to be the main reason you're going to want to update from iOS 15.2 or 15.2.1 and earlier. So the first thing is a fix for the major Safari data leak bug. So this made headlines everywhere. It was pretty big news. And this bug would basically leak your browsing history and Google IDs. So this has been patched with iOS 15.3. You can confirm this on safarileaks.com. This is how they basically demonstrated this working. And now when you test it, you can see it shows I'm not logged in to my Google account, when in fact I actually am. So it has been fixed. And you can see right here that the vulnerability that was exploited was in IndexedDB, which is a JavaScript API used to store data, and it would gain access to your recently visited URLs along with the Google IDs and the profile pictures that were currently logged in. So this is a pretty big bug and definitely a reason that Apple wanted to get this version out as soon as possible. So thankfully, this has been patched with iOS 15.3. We also have a few other security patches in this update as well. So a few minor ones. One that I noticed here though is an iCloud bug that's been fixed, and it says the impact is that an application may be able to access a user's file. So that's an interesting patch here in 15.3. We also have a few kernel bugs and some WebKit bugs that have also been patched. So just keep that in mind, along with the WebKit storage bug as well, which we just talked about. That is the IndexedDB bug that we just mentioned. So some pretty important bug fixes here in terms of security. Always a good reason to update to the latest version. And if you want to read all of this, I will leave this section on Apple's website down in the description below. We also get a fix for CarPlay. So if you are a CarPlay user and you use Apple Music, if you noticed with the previous versions, Apple Music would default to the library screen, but now it defaults back to the now playing screen when you access the Apple Music app. Also, the thumbnails for HomeKit cameras are fixed with iOS 15.3. So in 15.2.1, the HomeKit camera thumbnails or the snapshots would not update frequently. So now that has been patched with 15.3, it works properly now. The Apple Music pausing bug also seems to be fixed with this update. So sometimes it would just randomly pause and it had nothing to do with connectivity or anything like that. So that does appear to be fixed. I've not faced that one time since updating. And as far as the iPhone storage bug, this also appears to be fixed with iOS 15.3. Now, me personally, I've not had this bug on any of my devices. I've really tried to replicate this and reproduce this, but I cannot. So if you do have this issue, if you had it in the past and it has been fixed with this update, let me know down in a comment below. But for most people, this does appear to be fixed, and it now shows the proper amount of storage used and the proper amount available. And if you have an Apple Watch Series 7, the major charging bug that only affected the Apple Watch Series 7 has been fixed with the watchOS 8.4 update, which came out alongside iOS 15.3. So if you had any issues with charging, especially with third-party cables, just keep in mind that that bug has been fixed. And then we also have a minor change to HomePod OS 15.3. So you can see here when you go to download the new version of the HomePod software, you can see it now shows that 15.3 adds Siri voice recognition support for up to 6 users in a home in English, India, and Italian, Italy. This update also includes performance and stability improvements. So very minor, very specific fixes, but that is also new here with 15.3 for the HomePod. And then finally, the notification summary bug has also been fixed here, where some people are not able to clear their notifications from the summary. They would have to clear the entire notification summary from their lock screen. So if you had any issues with that, that should be fixed here with 15.3 as well. Now, as far as performance goes, performance feels excellent with 15.3. It feels smoother than iOS 15.2 and 15.2.1, but keep in mind, it's still early on and gauging the performance takes a little bit of time. So I will report back to you in my follow-up review on Saturday if the performance has improved any or if it's taken a hit from 15.2.1, which I doubt, because iOS 15.3 has honestly been really, really good. It's been great performance-wise since beta 1. I even made a comment saying that the first beta of 15.3 was actually probably the best performing first beta of any iOS version I've ever tested. So iOS 15.3 seems to be the best version of iOS 15 so far, as it should be, but it is nice to see that performance is excellent here with the new update. The Geekbench scores are also pretty strong as well. So if we go ahead to the Geekbench here and check out these scores. So we got a 1739 on the single core and a 4823 on the multi-core. So pretty strong scores there for iOS 15.3, and it shows it performs really well. Now, as far as the battery life goes, battery life is also excellent here in 15.3. It's really been great ever since the first beta, just like the performance, which is impressive. But I would say that it's about 20 to 30 minutes more of on-screen time in my testing on average over 15.2.1. So pretty solid battery life there. It's always great when there's a minor improvement over the previous version. But once again, I will continue testing this and letting you guys know if I notice any more improvements or maybe the battery drops off. I'll let you guys know in my follow-up video this weekend. But so far, so good for battery life. All right, so now should you update to iOS 15.3? And I say absolutely. So unlike the last update, 15.2.1, iOS 15.3 provides more changes and bug fixes than that update, along with a major security patch that you're gonna want to be protected from. So yeah, also you might notice some improvements to the performance and battery life with this update, which is also a plus. And if you do notice anything, let me know in a comment down below, because of course it does always depend on your device and everybody's experience is different, but I would love to hear from you down in those comments below. I do love reading those. But anyways, let's move on to what is next for Apple. What can we expect to see next from Apple in terms of software? So I think that an iOS 15.3.1 is possible that could come at some point in February to fix up some bug that we probably don't even know about right now. Or of course there could be some sort of security issue that comes out, just like with the Safari bug that we saw fixed in this update. So I would not be surprised to see a 15.3.1 at some point within the next couple of weeks, but we should also be seeing iOS 15.4 enter the beta stages really as early as this week or possibly even next week. So iOS 15.4 is most likely going to be the update that brings the wallpapers and emojis. Now Apple could wait until iOS 15.5 to release the new wallpapers and new emoji, but I'm hoping they come in 15.4. And of course we will know in due time. I would expect 15.4, the final release, to come at the end of February, possibly into early March, but we'll have to wait and see how those beta stages go for 15.4. But anyways, that is what to expect next from Apple. And that's everything new as well on iOS 15.3. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss all my future iOS update videos. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.